thanks everyone for joining 2K Sports for this Wednesday evening presentation of the NBA. And tonight, we've got the Phoenix Suns playing against the Toronto Raptors at Scotiabank Arena. And along with Grant Hill and Doris Burke, I'm Brian Anderson, joined by Allie LaForce, our reporter. Allie, it's all yours.
Kyle Lowry last season broke the Raptors' all-time record for assists. It was also his sixth straight All-Star selection. But he said, quote, "I am never complacent. How I got here was through hard work, so why stop now? Guys, the lead guard spot is a nightly challenge. He knows he's got to be on point."
Yes, he does. Thanks, Allie. Good stuff there. Boy, a high-tempo game tonight. Both teams like to get out and run.
And B.A., we always talk about pace. Well, this will be all about pace. Get your popcorn and your track shoes ready, because these teams like to get up and down the court. Not a whole lot of defense played, but a lot of high-powered offense. It should be a fun one to watch.
All right, now the opening lineup for Phoenix. We've got Mikal Bridges, Chris Paul out there with Devin Booker. Then it's DeAndre Ayton, and it's Smith in at the four. And for the Raptors, at the forward spots, it's Ananobi and Siakam. Lowry and Powell are the backcourt set, and it's Baines in at the five. Now here's Booker. Oh, great D that time from Powell. And here's Lowry. Outside Ananobi. Powell outside. Pass to Siakam. Shot clock at six. The Raptors need to get off a shot. They grab their own miss. Second chance shot. Lowry, no good.
Boy, defense nowhere to be found, and neither was his shot at that time.
Here's Bridges. Checked by Baines. Bridges misses.
Well, he's a quality mid-range shooter, but he can't get that one to go.
Siakam outside. Here he goes. That shot missing. Nice D from Bridges. Here in the first, a little over a minute played so far. Smith right side. Pass to Booker. Now here's Lowry.
And I'll tell you what, this young man is known for his shooting. But make no mistake, Devin Booker is an all-around scorer. He has a chance to really be one of the elite players in this league. He's got a lot in his bag.
Now here's Bridges. How about that strong defensive performance for this half's mobile one block?
Yeah, just a little intimidation right away. Got to show those shooters you're going to be there all night long.
The Raptors have gone 0 for 5 to begin this game. And with the league going 3 crazy, Devin Booker is cutting down his attempts from long range the last few seasons.
And I love that he's doing that, B.A. He's attacking the rim or, but also very comfortable in the mid-range. He just does a really good job of taking what the defense gives him. I love how he can mix and match his ability to score. And, of course, he takes advantage of those opportunities.
Timeout called. The Suns.
I don't think this timeout is just to give the guys a breather. Coach is looking to switch things up.
And as you know, it's what comes after that gives you some sense of what has changed.
Here's Paul. Fires from the wing, and the jumper is on the mark.
There is a relentlessness to what Chris Paul does. This guy works at his own pace, wears you out, searching for his shot.
Now here's Lowry. And Kyle Lowry is going to pick up the foul. That's his first foul of the game.
And this kind of selflessness is great to see. Textbook positioning to draw the charge.
First quarter of ball, almost 2.5 minutes in. Outside Paul. And it's Toronto with a rebound.
Boy, if you're going up against this guy in this close a range, you've got to defend with everything you've got. A tremendous job defensively.
Now here's Powell. Beyond the arc. And Kyle Lowry gets the three.
But Kyle Lowry can do it all. He is an outstanding passer. But when necessary, as it was right here, knock down the catch and shoot jumper.
Ayton against Baines. Back to Ayton. And he floats it in for the easy two. Credit the sweet setup on that one.
Just taking it right to the rim, and no one was there to greet him.
And I think defensively, that is not the way you want to start. Giving up high percentage looks, that doesn't typically end well.
The shot by Baines, no good. The Suns leading. First quarter of play, and just over 3.5 minutes in. The three from Ayton. Yes! And it's Paul with the assist that time. Ayton's got five.
Night after night, game after game, Chris Paul understands where to put the ball and when. Nicely done.
Baines, a screen on Paul. Here's Bridges. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game from him. And he's in the books. Now one for two.
Such a smart offensive player. Mikal Bridges assertive and focused when he gets this close.
Siakam with it. Now guarded by Ayton. Out to Powell. Can they get it? Pure from three-point range.
He's consistent from out there, especially when you give him that kind of room.
Paul with it. Bridges right side. Pass to Paul. Out to the wing. And here's Bridges. Six to shoot. Now Booker. The three. It's rebounded by Pascal Siakam. Now Powell. Lowry outside. With some arc. And that's 2 points on the layup. 5 points in the game.
You know this, a guy at Lowry's size has simply got to be able to make the floater. That's a big-time delivery.
To the left wing. Back to Paul. Down low. Here's Booker. Yes! And it's Paul with the assist that time.
And he gives up some size inside, but makes a great adjustment on the finish.
Well, he's attacking, he's forcing the issue, and that's simply stated a terrific play.
Here's Siakam. That shot off. So Phoenix will take it the other way. And here's Paul. Over to the wing. Pass to Booker. Fires the three. And it's Booker again missing.
Right now trying to get into a rhythm, but so far this quarter, boy, he is struggling to make anything go down.
Oh, they get a hand on it. Stolen by Ayton. Now here's Paul. Now Ayton. He's covered by Siakam. Back to Paul. Unloads from 13. Another shot. And Ayton with the lay-in. Ayton's got 7 points in the game.
What a fantastic offensive rebounder. Ayton's so good at using his physical advantages.
Timeout called. The Raptors.
And of course, DeAndre Ayton was the number one pick in the 2018 draft. But you think about the number three pick being Luka Doncic and the number five pick in Trae Young both becoming all-stars. There's a lot of pressure on Ayton to succeed. But Monty Williams and the Phoenix Suns remain patient with Ayton, and I think they should.
A big group substitution here for Toronto. Boucher's checked in for Baines. Thomas comes in for Anunoby. Davis, he's checked in for Powell. And Van Vliet is subbed in for Lowry. Now here's Van Vliet. To the right side. Back to Davis. To the inside. Clock at six. Pass to Thomas. The three is up. No good that time.
Yeah, and the defense has really got to tighten up on him. I mean, he's just too dangerous from the three-point line.
Now here's Ayton. Here's Diallo. Oh, and the jam by Ayton.
This is the kind of damage DeAndre Ayton can do if he gets the right positioning. Nicely done.
Boucher with it. Outside Davis. Let's it fly. And that one no good to start off tonight. Phoenix with the ball. They're on a 13-5 run. Carter against Davis. Carter inside. Yep, that one goes. And now it's a 9-point Suns lead.
And adding to this lead right now, riding a wave of momentum.
Well, if you continue to execute at both ends, you can build on this lead.
Now here's Van Vliet. What, no scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. Pass to Siakam. The shot comes out. And so the first quarter is in the books. The Suns on top, leading by 9. And the second quarter is on its way when we return. And reminiscing about his championship year with Kawhi Leonard, Pascal Siakam shared this with us.
He was always a team. And I think we don't look at one player and say he's going to save us. You know, we got to save each other. We got to play for each other.
And that's how Siakam plays the game himself.
Yeah, versatile, very unselfish, and a franchise player in his own right.
Great to have you with us. Second quarter of basketball. This game has not exactly been neck and neck, but plenty of time left in this one. All right, guys, what stands out to you from the Suns in this one?
The aggressiveness on defense has been infectious. Everyone's come to the party. I love it.
Well, I think they combined great intelligence with great effort, and you can see the results.
Terrence Davis out there with Fred VanVleet. Then it's Matt Thomas. Then it's Pascal Siakam. And it's Boucher in at the 5. So that's the 5 in the game for Toronto. Now here's Siakam, looking for his first basket still in this one.
And they had early success from the perimeter, but I don't understand how they've gotten away from that here in the second.
Starting the second quarter, about a minute gone. Pass to Johnson. Suns keep it alive. Tries again. Ayton, no good.
Listen, offensively, they're very comfortable with him taking that shot. It's a good look under very little pressure. He just can't convert.
Ooh, Ayton with the block. Carter with it. Second quarter of action, about a minute and a half play to the paint. Here's Ayton. Hey, in 6 attempts, he's made 5. Talk about efficiency.
And force feeding the ball inside. I mean, no reason to go away from what's working.
They've been having major problems offensively.
Definitely in a bit of a dry spell.
Tries the spin move, and Siakam gets it to go.
Wow, finishing through contact with a beautiful display of focus. What a job by Pascal Siakam through contact.
Here's Diallo. Pass to Johnson. Here's Diallo. Now Carter. Here's Ayton.
Oh, look at that.
Oh my goodness!
Good night.
Cocked it back and fired it home.
Go ahead, Mr. Ayton. How about that finish?
Van Vliet outside. For Phoenix, they've got 3 of 6 shots to go here in the second quarter. Here in quarter 2, we've played a little over 2.5 minutes now. Here's Ayton. Uses the glass to finish the layup. Ayton's got 6 in the quarter. Boy, one trend we've seen over the years in the NBA, Grant, is an increase in the number of possessions per game.
And NBA, that's by design. You know, back in the early 2000s, the NBA wanted to speed up the game. They took away some of the physicality in the game. And as that happened, it coincided with the embracing of the three-point shot. And so now the pace has picked up. It's more up and down. It's exciting to watch. I think for the players, they enjoy playing this style of basketball, and that has contributed in large part to the number of possessions growing and increasing as it is in today's game.
Never been as fast, never been as skilled as it is right now in the NBA.
Very true. Protecting the rim has to be their top objective right now.
And the question they're going to have to answer to me is it a problem with the scheme or is it a problem with matchups?
Now here's Van Vliet. Well, he hasn't put up any points yet in this one. And down it goes, 2 points.
Well, use the pick and going right to the cup. I love the aggressiveness.
Paul with it, picked up by Lowry. Pass to Johnson. Yes, and it's Paul with the assist that time. Johnson's gotten himself going here. His first points of the game on the deep ball. Lowry outside. No good with the triple.
You have to credit their effort. I mean, they've done an amazing job on the glass.
Outside Paul. Deflected! Van Vliet outside. Pass to Ananobi. Lowry against Paul. Phoenix has gone 2 for 2 from outside the arc here in the second quarter. Here's Johnson inside. It's stolen by Baines. Ananobi finds Lowry. And here's Baines. Back to Lowry. That one's good. Makes him 3 for 7.
I tell you, this guy just loves having the ball in his hands. And why not when Lowry can make moves like that?
Well, throughout his career, Kyle Lowry has been fantastic on defense. As tenacious as a defender as they come, Grant.
B.A., one of my favorite players in the league. I mean, of course, Lowry's small, but has a low center of gravity. Bigger guards can't move him, and he can stay with all the smaller guards, too. Lowry's elite when it comes to taking charges.
Count it. Van Vliet's got 4 points now in the quarter.
Well, you love to see Norman Powell be unselfish and find an open teammate. That's pretty.
It's Bridges on the wing. Outside Paul. Just 5 on the clock. And the layup is good. Paul's gotten his second bucket of the game.
Chris Paul is the master of the pick and roll, understanding how to utilize his teammates to the best of their abilities.
Suns on D. Lowry outside.
Listen, he can make that shot right there, but I do know they have other options they can go to.
Here's Okobo, right wing. Here's Paul. Rebound by Van Vliet. Outside Ananobi. Powell right side. Fires from deep. Buries it from three. Powell's got 6 points.
Absolutely critical that Norman Powell expand his range. The more he makes that three, the more the floor opens up.
Here's Okobo. Ananobi covering. They set a pick. Just 4 to shoot. Stolen by Lowry. Here comes Toronto on the push. And the deficit down inside single digits. He's got 9.
Well, that's Kyle Lowry, the burst of speed to beat everyone up the floor and leaves no doubt with the finish.
.119 left in the second quarter. Man, the Suns miss again.
Well, it hasn't been the most efficient game for this guy, but their team is fortunate to still be out in front.
Hits the trifecta.
Well, there is absolutely no doubt that Kyle Lowry can shoot with range. He can make you pay from out there.
It's Bridges on the wing. Count it. Bridges has got his second basket on the night.
They're not rolling like they were earlier. The bucket's a little harder to come by.
Van Vliet outside. Powell outside. No good from outside. For Phoenix, they've gotten 7 shots out of 14 attempts in the second quarter. Here's Okobo, checked by Baines. Shot clock at 6. Pass to Booker. Launches it. Connects from downtown. And now a 10-point Phoenix lead.
You have to be able to think quickly and make great decisions. And in the catch and shoot, Devin Booker doing work.
Lowry outside. And that concludes the first half. Suns ahead, leading by 10. And don't go away. After the break, we'll see you right back here for the start of quarter number 3.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello, basketball fans. What a pleasure it is to bring you into the 2K studios again. Ernie Johnson, Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny the Jet Smith. DeAndre Ayton was on fire in the first half. He ended up with 15 points, 3 block shots, and 8 rebounds. He's been in the midst of some incredible games lately, and tonight, he's got it going again. Let's hear from you, Shaq, on the Suns.
Dominating performance by Ayton, showing good agility for his size, understands how to play the game. His success at the offensive end is a big reason why they're up.
Looking at Toronto, Kenny, your thoughts.
Their rebounding was an issue. I don't think that they showed the toughness that they need. It'll be a focus for them in the second half, I'm sure. They need to establish a physical presence inside.
And that's going to do it for our halftime show, sadly. Third quarter about to start. See you again after the final
horn. Oh, buzzer.
And we've got third quarter basketball here. 2 quarters in the books. We're seeing a tremendous game from DeAndre Ayton.
Through the first 2 quarters, he's been on fire. Explosive offensive performance.
Boy, he has been shouldering the load. Aggressive, skilled, talented, and thus far, unstoppable.
And we hope you've enjoyed the broadcast thus far. We're halfway through the game. Toronto shooting 37% from the floor at this point. And so, in the game for Phoenix, we've got Chris Paul, also Devin Booker out there. DeAndre Ayton is out there with Mikal Bridges. And it's Smith in at the 4-man position. Here's Lowry. Finds the bottom from 13 feet out. Lowry's got 14 points.
Well, get to that sweet spot. Nice mid-range jumper by Kyle Lowry. So effective.
Outside Paul. It's Booker on the wing. The kick out to Paul. Ayton.
Well, the offensive game will round into shape over time, and it's absolutely critical that DeAndre Ayton look to score as much as possible.
All right, let's check in with Allie LaForce.
Coach Monty Williams has really revitalized the Suns. Devin Booker said the culture's different. You can feel it in the air. It started with Monty. His voice travels. We all believe in him. He believes in us, and it's contagious. Guys, it's so important to have that buy-in.
Can't do it without it. No doubt. Thanks, Allie. Doris, Mikal Bridges, he's a great pairing with Devin Booker. He's also able to space the floor for him and take on those more challenging defensive assignments.
That's right, because Mikal Bridges has a 7'1" wingspan, and this is a team that often goes small at the forward spots. So to get more spacing while still having the length and physical abilities to challenge defensively, so critical, such a good fit.
That's good from Siakam. All right, Grant, if you're thinking about an ideal NBA backcourt, what's the makeup look like for you?
B.A., the NBA backcourt has really changed dramatically. You think about guys like LeBron James and Giannis Antetokounmpo, James Harden. The ball is in their hands a lot during the games. They're not your traditional backcourt. But I do think the skill set necessary, you have to be able to shoot the ball. You have to be able to play with the ball in pick and roll. You got to be a facilitator, be able to be create your own shot and shots for others. It's really interesting how the NBA backcourt has changed through the years.
Evolving like the rest of the game. Now here's Powell. Shoots over Booker, and the Raptors miss again. And here's Paul. It's Booker on the wing. Missed inside.
Well, defensively, if you allow him to get this close, you're playing with fire. He just happened to miss that one.
Powell outside. There's the three. And the foul called on Aaron Baines. That's his first foul of the game. And we've got to see that sensational mobile one block again.
It's simple. I mean, when you're behind in the game, that's what you got to do. Contest every shot.
And some changes here for the Raptors. Boucher's checked in for Baines. Thomas comes in for Anunoby. And it's Davis in for Powell. The Suns have gone 2 of 5 in this third quarter. To the middle. And Ayton gets it to go. Ayton's gotten 4 this quarter.
And now almost all their points coming from the paint.
Offensively, it's been a struggle for them.
Yeah, they need to string together some shots to have any kind of chance.
And that one's good.
Well, Siakam pushing right through the contact. Go ahead, young sir.
Pass to Diallo. Here's Johnson. Puts up a 3. Here's Ayton. Second half of play, and we're 3 minutes into the third here. Here's Thomas. Booker defending. And here's Siakam for 3. And Booker pulls it down.
And right now, they're +8 in the rebounding category. That's helping them run away with this.
No coverage that time. 6 points for him.
Well, that's the court awareness of Mr. Devin Booker. This guy increasingly becoming such a good passer.
Boucher outside. Siakam outside. And he drives in. Phoenix grabs the miss. Ayton's got a rebound number 12 here already in the game. Outside Booker. Looking to get it going. And Booker with the jam.
Well, you love watching Devin Booker finish with power. He refuses to settle for the layup. Nice aggressiveness there.
Siakam outside. Takes it inside. Misses from close range.
I know he's got to be frustrated right now, but the team is fighting from behind. He's got to stay with it.
Pass to Diallo. Back to Booker. Ayton, a screen on Siakam. For 3, Booker. Here's Ayton. Second shot opportunity. That's his 3rd miss of the game. 9 for 12 overall. The Raptors have gotten only 2 of 7 shots to go in the third quarter. Now here's Lowry. 14 points for him. And it's Siakam again missing.
Sometimes you just have an off day, and this is one of those games for him.
Pass to Booker for 3. Here's Ayton. But he stays with it. Tries yet again. And he was fouled in the act of shooting. Opportunity for a 3-point play here.
And they're up considerably because of their efforts on the glass.
You look at DeAndre Ayton and the physical attributes he has, and you think he has all the tools to be a defensive anchor. What he's developing is the IQ to maximize his impact on that end.
One shot.
Van Vliet's checked in for Lowry. And a change for the Suns. Carter's checked in. The free throw's off from Ayton. Boy, Ayton with elite defensive field goal percentage. When he's nearby, shooters beware, Doris.
And that's because, B.A., this guy with his quick feet, he can close out with the best of them. It's all about staying down, use your length, not fighting on pump fakes. That awareness is what will put him over the top.
And the Suns making a change here. That's good from Siakam.
And there's a lot to admire about how Pascal Siakam attacks defenders. I mean, he's so shifty outside, and he absorbs contact so well when he gets to the rim. He's stronger than you'd think from looking at his frame.
Sinks it from distance. Johnson's got 6 points.
Their ball movement on this run has been tremendous. It's led to a lot of good, clean, open looks.
Davis with it. Now quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game. Boucher on the screen. The drive by Van Vliet. And he banks in the layup. Sneaky strength of Siakam. It's one of the reasons why he's such a tough matchup.
He really is a tough matchup. He will put bigger guys on skates out there on the perimeter. Of course, he can still play back to the basket on the block. There's no easy answer for how you match up with Siakam. And he just powered through contact trying to complete the play.
Shooting two.
And he can't get the first one. And Grant, since the conclusion of your playing career, you've spent the better part of a decade covering the game on television. So what's been your favorite part of that aspect of your career?
You know, B.A., it's been incredible. I mean, I've enjoyed every aspect of covering games. And I think for me, it's being so close to the action, getting a chance to almost get lost in the game, feeling like you're in the game as we get a chance to watch these amazing athletes go up and down the court. It's the closest thing to actually playing, being right here next to you, calling the games.
And great makeup, too, Grant.
Always.
And finished off by Boucher.
Well, you love the unselfishness of Fred VanVleet. This guy is so good recognizing when his teammates are open.
1:14 left in the third quarter here. Pass to Johnson. The three. It's hauled in by the Raptors. And he was fouled while in the act of shooting, so he'll take 2 free throws.
Boy, Pascal Siakam gives you absolutely everything you want from the modern NBA forward. He can score inside, he can score outside. He's effective in transition. He's starting to become a focal point in the half court. What incredible growth from Pascal.
He's off on the first.
And after attempting no free throws in the first half, now he's putting the defense back on its heels.
And some changes here for the Raptors. Baines comes in for Boucher, and it's Anunoby in for Davis. And he sinks the second.
I think, guys, maybe what you appreciate most about Pascal Siakam is his versatility. He can score from a number of areas. He can guard multiple positions. There is a lot to like about this young man.
Toronto's gone 0 for 2 from outside here in the third. 41 seconds left in the third, and he gets it to go. Siakam's got 9 points in the quarter.
I'll tell you, you have got to have a short memory. You put a poor first half behind you, and you get to work here in the second.
Back to Paul. Out left to the wing. Let's a floater go. The putback. It's good on the putback. Ayton's got 23 points.
Well, the advantage they have right now is largely based on his play. What an outstanding night.
Now here's Siakam, covered by Smith. Siakam outside. Baines with a screen.
Just showing some tremendous authority controlling the boards. Love it.
Wow, what a performance. And he's not just winning with physical ability, he's winning with anticipation.
Well, through three quarters of play, down double digits, it may be difficult to overcome. Suns ahead. They lead by 13. Don't go anywhere. The final quarter is coming up next on 2K Sports. And while we have a chance, let's go to our State Farm assist of the game.
Talk about painting a magnificent picture with that dime. Just a great decision and a perfect delivery.
We call that putting it right in the pocket, and he knew what to do with it once it was there.
And we reach the fourth quarter in a game that may already be out of hand. Van Vliet the two, with Powell sliding in at the three. OG Anunoby out there with Aaron Baines. And it's Lowry in at the point. That's the five out there for the Raptors. Out of bounds. The Raptors will take it. A difficult situation for Toronto. Inside. Here's Baines. He can't get that one to fall. Ayton with the defensive effort. Bridges outside. To the wing on the left. Pass to Booker. Here's Paul. Rebounded by Baines. Baines has got 6 rebounds now in the game.
Boy, this guy just can't buy a bucket, and yet they have the advantage.
Van Vliet, the pass to Baines. Shoots over Paul. Powell outside from downtown. The Suns clear it. Smith's got 4 rebounds now. Paul passes to Ayton. Smith outside. Six on the shot clock. Bridges on the attack. Banked it in off the glass. And the Suns lead by 15.
If you overplay Mikal Bridges to take the jump shot, that's creating driving lanes, and he'll take advantage.
Here's Lowry. Paul with some nice D. The Suns shooting 46%, a decent average so far. To the inside. Oh, and the jam by Ayton.
He's carried this team to this lead on his back, handling almost all the scoring duties.
Baines with a screen. Lowry into the lane.
Boy, a little indecisive. I think he wanted to kick it out, changed his mind, and ended up missing.
Paul passes to Ayton. Oh, stolen by Anunoby. Lowry finds Anunoby. Back to Lowry. Oh, and there's the whistle on the shot. So 2 free throws for him coming up. It goes on Chris Paul.
Well, he may not have the physical tools that some other players have, but Kyle Lowry is physical, he's imposing his will, and he will take some contact.
Two shots. Last on the first.
First one falls.
Well, you think about Kyle Lowry and the trajectory of his career. I think it's hard to remember. Coming out of Villanova, those first few seasons, he was not getting a ton of minutes. Gets more of an opportunity with Houston, and then ultimately ends up in Toronto and becomes one of the driving forces in the most successful eras of the organization.
And so he's able to get one of two. You know, Doris, with Lowry, he's one of the most respected guards in the NBA.
This young guy carves his way into a six-time All-Star, more importantly, NBA champion. He put in the work, he puts in the competitive spirit, and this guy just plays smart, winning basketball.
Just three to shoot. Fade away. Offensive rebound. Ayton. Oh, and makes it with the kiss. Ayton's got 12 points here in the second half.
Yeah, more points coming from inside. In that respect, they've been the more aggressive team.
Here's Lowry. Will not go. Misses off the front iron. For Phoenix, they've gone 3 of 5 since this fourth quarter started. And Ayton with the stuff.
The B.A., when he gets the rim in his sights, it's tough to stop.
So aggressive and a determined finisher. Nice. And he comes up with a bucket.
Well, nice finish from that point. Kyle Lowry's got a ton of ways to score once he gets into that painted area.
Pass to Johnson. From outside the arc, hits a three-pointer. And the Suns lead by 21.
The assist numbers certainly stand out. They've really emphasized ball movement here today.
Outside Ananobi. Now Baines. Lowry outside. Fires the three. Lowry with another miss.
Well, two long-range bombs in the first, but that's stalled out right now.
Here's Bridges. They get the rebound to the paint. Ayton, a screen on Powell. Booker for three. Drops in the three.
And looking to shoot as many threes as possible. This kind of confidence, impressive to see.
Lowry, the pass to Powell. Back to Lowry. From deep. Gets the three ball to go. Lowry's got 6 points in the quarter.
Here in the second half, you see they've gone to the long ball to try to keep up.
Lowry against Paul. Down low. And Booker the bucket on the assist by Paul. Paul's got his sixth assist of the night.
Boy, absolutely no rim protection, leading to a lot of easy buckets here.
Lowry outside. Three-pointer. It's hauled in by the Suns. Now Paul. Pass to Johnson. Over Boucher. No good. A bit long that time. Powell outside. Boucher outside. Back to Powell. And there's the drive. Well, a breakthrough season for Norman Powell in 2020. Just about doubled his scoring average. And Grant, he did it with elite efficiency.
NBA Powell has shown time and time again that he can light it up. He is great from anywhere on the floor. When he gets going, he can take over a game.
Two shots. Last on the first.
And the first one at the line is good.
Well, one thing there's no question about is that Norman Powell is a gifted athlete. Now it's about rounding out that game, particularly his shooting.
Pascal Siakam, he's checked in for Toronto. And that's good as he hits both shots. Here's Paul. Shot clock at 6. Jacks up a 3. The shot that time not on target. And it's the Raptors taking it the other way. Powell against Booker.
And they're ahead right now because they're working so hard on the glass.
And bottom line, more boards means more possessions. That's how you build a lead.
Back to Paul. Driving inside. Pass to Johnson. Let's go with a three. Yes! And it's Paul with the assist that time. Paul's got assist number 7 tonight.
And let's face it, this one was never really in question. They came out with purpose and just overwhelmed the opposition. A great win for the Suns.
And you don't usually see this kind of blowout, but tonight they delivered the punishment.
I mean, what's so impressive is they never wavered in their approach. They just kept at it and showed they were without a doubt the better team.
Powell, it's good.
And talk about payback. He hits the revenge triple.
Oh, you love to see the competitive fire, a little bit of pride at stake.
Paul finds Booker. Hayden with it to the wing, right side. Here's Paul. Softly drops in the floater.
Finishing the game strong. This is how you shut the door on any hopes of a comeback.
No question. They've gotten hot at exactly the right time. Clutch play on a team level.
Lowry. Ooh, lots of contact on the shot. So 2 free throws will follow that whistle. And there's the foul against Phoenix. That free throw good from Lowry.
I think now that he's become a perennial all-star, it's easy to forget. It wasn't until his 9th year in the league that Kyle Lowry made his first all-star game.
Both free throws good from Lowry. Here's Okobo. 3-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Pass to Owens. That one's good for 2.
What a performance tonight. Getting a win like this on the road is such a boost.
You've got to be able to block out all distractions in enemy territory. This team did a tremendous job staying focused on the task at hand.
Here's McCaw. So no problem for Phoenix as they get the win. A statement road victory. So impressive.
Statement indeed, BA. It was in enemy territory, but they controlled the game and took the crowd completely out of it. That's how you win on the road.
Well, folks, that's going to do it for now. For Allie LaForce, Doris Burke, and Grant Hill, this is Brian Anderson alongside our 2K Sports crew thanking you for watching. So long, everyone.